musicians, I guess, students, adjudicators, special guests, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Laurie Jarvis, and I am very pleased to be able to welcome you to Musicfest Nelson 1990. And boy, is this place full. This is just great. I hope that's an indication of how wonderful a day that you all have had. Just before we get started here, if I could just have your attention for a couple of minutes. One of the small problems that we might have is that because this area is so full, I have to ask the people at the back to move so that the fire exits are clear. So if you want to find another place where you can see, yeah, whoa, God, look at that, it's standing room only. They're outside the back windows and everything. That's great. Yeah, we're really full. So if there should happen to be anything that happens, because we're so full, you'll have to keep the stairs clear and make sure that all the exits are clear so that if, heaven forbid, there should be a bolt of lightning come down from the sky, we'll all be able to get out. So I'll let you know what to do. Just listen for my voice. I guess today has been a really, really hectic day of performing and listening and adjudicating and learning in all of the workshop situations. You've all done your work for today. Now it's time to sit back and relax and be treated by two superb musical groups that are here to entertain you tonight. First group you're going to hear is from Eastern Washington University, their symphonic band. The second group you're going to hear is Voice Deco from Oshowa, Ontario. But before we get started, I would like to introduce the chairman of School District Number 7, Jan Lindsay, and our MLA, Howard Dirks, for a few short words. So Jan and Howard.
Thank you, Laurie. Good evening, and welcome to Musicfest 1990. Boy, what an exciting event. I must admit, I really got caught up in all of the excitement this morning as I was heading off to work. I passed the North Shore Inn and saw two huge buses sitting there, and got to Peebles and saw another four lined up along the highway just below there. And then as I'm driving to Castlegar, I think at least 10 passed me coming into Castlegar, and I thought, boy, it reminded me of the movie Sound of Music. I thought the hills of Nelson will certainly be alive with music this weekend. We are very pleased to host Musicfest 1990. We feel this is a tremendous educational experience for young people in our school district, and we see it as really a tremendous personal growth opportunity for you. I was really recently reminded about the value of this type of event when I was listening to a sports psychologist not long ago, and he was talking about practice and what is the most valuable type of practice. And he indicated the best kind of practice you can ever get is that when you're under the same level of stress or similar level of stress as you would be when you're actually performing. So I think Musicfest will really do that for you. Not only do you have an opportunity to play in front of an audience, also you have an opportunity to get the feedback from some very, very skilled adjudicators, and you also are exposed to some talents of very fine performers. So it is a tremendous opportunity, and I'm sure everybody will leave here feeling much more skilled and also motivated to make the very best of the abilities that you have. In addition to welcoming you here tonight, I would like to take this opportunity to express the board's appreciation to the person that is really the driving force behind this whole music fest, and that's a lady by the name of Helene McGall, our fine arts coordinator. And along with Helene this year, Helene has pretty much single-handedly organized this event for 3 years, but it's really grown out of all proportion. In fact, this year it is double. So this year she enlisted a very able committee, and I have some names here I just want to mention. Grace Wilson, Leah Gray, Eva Cox, Nancy Jones, Kathy Ballon, Brent Cross, and Marlene Garland. I know they've been a tremendous help to her, and they certainly have put together a fine festival. At this time, Helene, I'd like to ask you if you would mind coming up. We have a small token of our appreciation that we'd like to present to you on behalf of your efforts, your committee, and all the many volunteers that I know you have managed to enlist.
play Mr. Howard Dirks.
Thank you. If there was any doubt in my mind that Music Fest was on today, when I arrived in town, I not only saw the buses, but the town was alive with the sound of youth and exuberance, and I can see it here tonight. And I'm sure that that's going to carry on throughout the Music Fest 90. You really have grown considerably. Jan was just saying how much you've doubled since last year. 4 years ago, you started out very humbly, and now 4,000 people, or 4,000 participants. Over 90 different groups have come here, and really that is due to the tremendous hard work that Helene has given over the years for this. And I'd really like to thank you on behalf of the province for the excellent work that you have done, and with your committee this year, it's obviously bigger and better. And really what I'd like to do while I've got you here, and I've got a captive audience, and politicians love captive audience, is tell you about next year, because you are involved in music. And next year we are going to welcome the world back to British Columbia, because we're going to take Music 91 throughout the province. And we're really going to turn these hills and the mountains alive with music. And we'll have festivals and whatnot throughout the province, and welcome people to come and join in into things like this and try and assist wherever possible to make this type of thing and others happen related to music throughout 91. And I know that if we have the exuberance that you've got, if we've got the diligent workers that you've got in the form of Helene McGall, I'm sure Music 91, the year of music, is going to be a great success. But to the organizers, to all the participants, my congratulations. It's going to be an excellent weekend, I'm sure, and I hope you enjoy and you come back again next year. Thank you very much for coming.
Okay, let's get started. The first group that is going to entertain you this evening has been on the road for the past couple of days. They've been to Spokane, they've been to Colville, and we are very pleased to have them here on their third and final stop at Music Fest Nelson. This is the Eastern Washington University Symphonic Band, and I would like to introduce their director, Mr. Patrick Winters.
Thank you. Thank you all very much. I know this has already been said 3 or 4 times this evening, and we've just gotten started, but what a wonderful audience. Have this much going on in this part of the world, this part of your country, in music education is just fabulous. And all of us on stage are very excited to see all these musicians here listening to other musicians and sharing their abilities. We'd like to continue now and do a piece that Helene asked us to do because it's one of the tunes on the required music list here at the Nelson Band Fest. It is Prelude, Siciliano, and Rondo by Malcolm Arnold. It was originally written for a British brass band, and John Painter from Northwestern University has taken that and arranged it extremely craftsmanlike for the contraband situation. It's in 3 short movements. The first is the prelude. It's kind of a fanfare in reverse, a fanfare that ends very light and delicately. And the lullaby Siciliano and a rousing rondo for the third movement. So this is Prelude, Siciliano, and Rondo by Malcolm Arnold. Thank you. Andy Turtle on the oboe solo. Andy.
We're going to beg your indulgence for just a second as we do a little housework here. We'd like to feature a composer that comes to Spokane every year and conducts the Spokane Symphony Orchestra. Of course, that's only about 15 miles from Cheney, where our university is. So Norman Layden, who guest conducts the orchestra once a year, is kind of dear to our heart. This is an opportunity to sort of show off some of our very fine percussionists. This is kind of in the same style of Leroy Anderson. A lot of you will know Leroy Anderson because of pieces like The Typewriter and Sleigh Ride that many of us play at Christmas time and that kind of thing. This is entitled Serenade for a Picket Fence. And this will feature Keith Nielsen on xylophone, Heidi Dishman on xylophone, and Sam Wallenhop on xylophone and marimba. This is about the time that the flutist and piccolo players are glad that you chose those instruments. The four percussionists. We have a 24-foot U-Haul truck we're traveling with, and about 95% of that is percussion equipment. And those guys, yes, hey, percussionists. I forget we're dealing with a room full of musicians, so you understand all of that very well. Okay, serenade for a picket fence. Very much. At Eastern Washington University, we have a number of small ensembles that we pull from the band. We have a flute choir that performed this afternoon in the flute clinic at 11 o'clock and also at 1 o'clock. There's a full-size percussion ensemble that you'll hear a little bit later on. We have a trombone choir, a tuba euphonium quartet, a symphony orchestra, which is, of course, much larger, a chamber wind ensemble, a jazz ensemble, marching band, pep band, lots of things happening at Eastern in terms of music. The guys that are getting ready behind me are part of the trombone choir, which will tonight make up the trombone quartet. And they're going to be playing actually a little bit more serious piece of music in four short movements. This is the Telemann No. 4 Concerto for trombone quartet. The trombone quartet. Thank you very much. The members of the trombone quartet are Tom Moulter, Steve Macko, Aaron Bragg, and Steve Churchwell. Once more, the trombone quartet. In a few minutes, you'll be meeting their instructor. But first, this is a piece that the band people in the audience will realize when we tell you it's a grade 5 to 6 piece. You know what that means. And it's been a lot of fun for us to work on this tune. It's entitled Welsh Variants by James Kernow, who's the director of bands at University of South Carolina. It's a piece that was taken from thematic material from the motion picture Empire of the Sun. And John Williams did that original score. And it borrows a folk song from the country of Wales, and takes that folk song and does a number of different things with it in variation form, hence the title Welsh Variants by James Kernow. Thank you. Thank you very, very much. We appreciate that. We're going to have some fun now with one of our faculty members. Professor Jody Davis is low brass instructor at Eastern Washington University. She teaches our trombones, our baritones, our euphoniums, and our tubas. And she's not a great big 400-pound guy. She's a beautiful, sweet, wonderful, caring. Did I get all those things right, Joe? Is that right? Yeah, okay. A wonderful teacher. We love her a lot. We'd like to feature Professor Jody Davis on the Bluebells of Scotland. Professor Jody Davis.
Thank you.
Everybody to stand up and stretch because you might need a break, but you've already done that, so that was marvelous. These guys are going to take a break, and we are going to go on with the next performing group. I want to go out and learn to play the trombone and the xylophone. Wow, that's just, this is just wonderful. While these guys rest their lips, we're going to be entertained by a group from Oshowa, Ontario. It's a group of six singers, and they have decided to take a year out of their university studies to pursue their love. Bye, guys. And they're going to do a bunch of numbers for us. They had been on an 11-day tour. They were in Vancouver. Now they're here, and then after that, it's back to Oshawa. So I would like to introduce Voice Deco.
Da da da, oh, and then there's several, ain't she sweet?
Oh,
she gets the word, next thing you know, it's on the stage.
But in time, repeated all the truth that I've been believing. What is saying? Another day. Seems like everything we used to say.
Magazines
with the twisted sense of vision, making rumors like religion. What a shame,
but it's the same. Da-do-do-da-do-da.
Seems like everything you used to tell.
Oh, but I believe in a sound that I would never ever fail.
Da-da, spread love, that is spread
eyes.
Spread love,
but that needs no disguise.
I've often said love.
What the world needs now,
tell me love is what we need.
Love, more love is what we need.
What the world needs now is love.
More love is what we need.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. As was announced, we are Voice Deco. We are from Oshawa, Ontario, which is about 45 minutes east of Toronto. And we are a vocal jazz a cappella sextet. A cappella music, in case you didn't know, is music that's sung without instruments. And that's mainly because we can't afford them. The next time we'd like to do for you now is an arrangement of a Beatles tune, Blackbird.
La, 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 la.
Yeah.
birds singing in the dead of night.
Singing all night.
Take these broken wings and learn to fly.
All your life.
You are only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbirds singing in the dead of night.
Singing all night.
Take these sunken eyes and learn to see.
Learn to see. All your life.
You are only waiting for this moment to be free.
Thank you very much. We'll just take this opportunity to introduce the members of the group. Starting from my far right, we have our alto, Miss Yuni Choi. Mario Vela Martinez, our bass. Thank you. Miss Heather Kissack, our mezzo soprano. Richard Jin, baritone. Shelly, way up top, soprano. And myself, I'm Carlos Miller Martinez, and I'm the resident tenor and noisemaker. When you first pick up a piece of music, you find that there are many, many different ways of singing it. And after you've heard about 40 million versions of Happy Birthday and about 42 million versions of Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, you begin to realize that there are many, many different styles that are available to the musician to sing in. The next song we'd like to sing for you hopefully represents a few of those styles, and coincidentally is also can also be found on the top 40. It's been on top 40 for about the past 14 weeks back in Ontario. It's pretty popular back there. Maybe you'll recognize it.
Camptown ladies sing this song.
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 This song, this song, this song.
Do da da do da do da do da. Camptown ladies sing this song. Do da do da. The Camptown raised up 5 miles long. Oh, do da day. I come down there with my hat caping. Do da do da. I go back home with a popcorn tin. Oh, do da day. Going to put all night.
Going to put all day. I'll bet my money on the bottom leg. Somebody bet on the bay.
The long tail filly and the big black horse. Do da do da do da do da. By the track and the boat car cross. Oh, do da day. The fine horse sticking in the big mud hole. Do da do da do da. Can't touch the fun with a 10 foot pole. Oh, do da day.
Do da going to run all night.
Run all day.
Run all day.
Money
on the ball, their legs. Somebody bet on the bay. Do da do da do da do da.
Oh,
do that day. Go to run.
Thank you very much. We'd like to perform for you now a song, excuse me, a song that was arranged by a gentleman who we've had a great fortune to be involved with over the past few years. You're all very fortunate to have out here a gentleman who has come from Quebec, a man who has made great differences in the vocal jazz movement. As it stands in Canada, he's added a very rich French flavor to the entire vocal jazz music and a movement, and it's just wonderful. This next piece was arranged by Mr. Réjean Marois. This is his arrangement of P.S. I Love You.
As I write this letter, send my love to you. Remember that I'll always be in love with you.
Remember that
We're going to do one more song for you today. It's a bit of a jazz standard.
Just a little bit. Oh, just a little bit. Oh, just a little bit. Oh.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Enjoy the rest of Music Fest 90 and enjoy the rest of tonight's performance by the Eastern Washington University Symphonic Band under the direction of Patrick Winters.
Thank you very, very much. We want to deviate just a little bit and dedicate this to all of our musicians, particularly our percussionists in the audience. At Eastern, as I mentioned before, have a lot of smaller ensembles that perform regularly and have their own rehearsal schedules, and the percussion ensemble is one of those. Generally, they do a lot of classical things. They do keyboard mallets and more classical types of pieces. But today we're going to do a piece that Keith Nielsen will introduce. Keith is the assistant director of the percussion ensemble. Would you welcome Keith Nielsen to the stage?
Thank you. Thank you very much. Appreciate that. I'm the guy who gets the stall time while we dig all the stuff out of the boxes here from our clinic this afternoon. What we like to do at Eastern Washington University is really kind of unique. Along with our normal studies in all the percussion areas, you know, concert percussion areas, we've started branching out in the last couple of years into more world percussion. And by world percussion, some of you who were in the clinic earlier this afternoon will know what I'm talking about, but we'd like to get into African, the original African drumming, African music, Brazilian music, Cuban music, even a little Mexican music. So what we're going to do tonight, we're going to give you kind of a medley of all of this stuff rolled up into one. We're going to start with a Cuban samba, as you would hear if you were over in, any place for carnival. It will segue right straight into a Mexican marimba piece, and most of you will probably recognize it, especially if you've ever seen the movie. It's the original version of La Bamba, not the one that they made the movie about, but the original Mexican version. Then we will end with two African dance patterns as they would do in their normal ritual dances. So this is the Eastern Washington University Percussion Ensemble. Thank you.
Thank you all very much. We'd like to do one more tune for you before we say goodnight, but there are a couple of announcements that are really, really important to us to make. The first one is we are so proud of Eastern Washington University and all the things that it stands for. Very strong academic base, and we're very proud of all the things our students do. We have over 100 fields of study and academic areas. And as you're walking out, feel free to grab some of the literature that's on the Eastern admissions table. If there's anything you can, we can ever do to help you out or to offer any kind of assistance, we'd love to do that. We have fallen in love with Canada, and most especially with the folks at Nelson. And there are opportunities for you to study in the United States if you'd like to do that. And we'd love to have you with us, either as part of the band program or in the academic, any academic field that you choose to study at Eastern. About half of the students in this ensemble are music majors, and the other half are majoring in other things. It could be physics, or medicine, or education, or athletics, or whatever. And we invite you to join us. We have financial aid available, music scholarships, and also reciprocity with Canada and the United States, so you can sometimes receive in-state tuition even though you're out of the country. And the other announcement that I want to make to you is very special too. We want you to know how much we really appreciate the hospitality that all the folks in Nelson have given to us. Our love affair with Nelson and BC really started when the fine band of Bruce Hunters from Rogers High School came and visited us not long ago, and we struck up a great friendship, and here we are, and we hope that that can be ongoing. It is really special, as you guys know, for musicians to play for almost 1,000 other musicians and to have you be such a wonderful, wonderful audience. We all appreciate you very much. If there's anything any of us can do for you, please don't hesitate to let us know. A special thanks to Helene McGall for all of her work. Is Helene still here? The coordinator of Musicfest 90. Is Helene still here? Helene, thank you very, very much. We'd like to finish up with a tune that we're just due for fun. Chances are there's something in this tune that you've all played at one time or another. We dedicate this to all the musicians. This is entitled Instant Concert.